from Simon & Schuster Audio. Speaking Effective English, your guide to acquiring new confidence in personal and professional communication. By Bettye Pierce Zoller, John Arthur Watkins, and Hugh Lampman. Read by the authors, with a foreword by Edward Asner.
We appreciate Edward Asner's thoughts on the state of the language in his foreword to Speaking Effective English.
I'm Edward Asner. As the saying goes, words is my business. I learned to love language at an early age as I grew up in Kansas City, Kansas, and more so when I started my acting career in Chicago. As a youngster, I was very much aware that a command of the spoken word was invaluable to achieving professional as well as personal success. One's voice is out there every day, making a positive, or a not-so-positive, impression on everyone with whom we come in contact. Yet so many people take their voice and the way they speak for granted. It's what they were born with, and they become so used to their voices that quite often they make no conscious attempt to improve the way they sound. A more pleasing resonance, cleaner articulation, and the choice of a more colorful and interesting vocabulary would certainly help. Most of our speech habits are ingrained by about the age of 7. Our speech is derived from listening to those close to us during those formative years, parents, other relatives, and close friends. Thus, the way we say things is a direct product of our early childhood listening environment. If at all, changes and speech improvements will come much later in life. Unfortunately, in today's educational system, public and private, there's a slow but constant dumbing down. Put simply, in order to give passing grades to move students toward advancement or graduation, there's less and less emphasis on young people learning how to effectively express themselves in conversation or in the area of public speaking. Unless young people seek out specialized voice and diction training in pursuit of an acting or a broadcasting career, most are dependent upon whatever is offered by their high school or college teachers, many of whom have not mastered these speech skills themselves. This program is most encouraging. It provides solid guidance and instruction in improving the use and sound of that most beautiful of instruments, the human voice, and also helps to sustain the quality of spoken standard American English. It's a pity that what passes for acceptable grammar and properly spoken English these days is often street talk or vulgar slang. While it is true that American English is a living language and therefore is constantly undergoing change, there's an art to making oneself adhere to proper and correct usage when speaking it. That art is seldom a natural knack, but with conscious effort it can be acquired by observing, studying, and practicing the basics of how the voice works, how thoughts are best conveyed to others, and how listeners are going to best comprehend what we're saying. Both as performers and as teachers, Ms. Zoller, Mr. Watkins, and Mr. Lampman have, over the years, developed a unique insight into how essential proper vocal expression is to those who want to progress in any field of endeavor. So whether you plan to communicate as a salesperson or as a telephone receptionist, hope to become a well-known actor or broadcaster, or just want to handle yourself well while speaking to corporate management, the sounds that come from your mouth will have a direct impact on your advancement. I've worked with some of the best actors in the world, in everything from sitcoms to Shakespeare. Many of these fine actors started out in disparate vocations as waitresses, salespeople, office workers, even as doctors and lawyers. But that acting bug, that urge to perform, was implanted somewhere along the way in their lives. Without exception, every one of these individuals realized early in their careers what a remarkable asset their voice and manner of speaking could be. They realized that speaking well was vital to winning auditions and to earning a living in their chosen craft. We're all actors, even if only in our everyday lives. Speaking effectively can enable us and empower us to move others to cry or laugh, to feel anger, to become inspired, all because of the power of the spoken word. On stage and in our homes and offices, we all must learn to communicate with style. I commend the authors of this audiobook for recognizing the need to improve one's voice and speech. And I commend you for dedicating yourself to taking this important step. Whether you want to be an Academy Award-winning actor, or if you're just trying to enhance the opportunities life brings your way, you owe yourself a huge pat on the back. You are taking an excellent first step by studying voice and speech improvement. Now persevere. I truly wish you well.
I'm Bettye Pierce Zoller. These are some of the sounds of speech. Loud, soft, harsh, pleasant. Sometimes understandable, sometimes unclear. There are many languages in the world. This audiobook is concerned with speaking effective American English. Whether you're a natural English speaker or, for you, English is a second or a foreign language, this program is intended to help you improve your speech. Everyone can always improve. We speak at least 1,000 words for every one that we write. Few skills are more important to an individual's well-being than the ability to speak clearly, persuasively, and effectively.
And I'm Hugh Lampman. Spoken language is really a series of sound signals. Humans signal each other by the words that they choose to convey their thoughts, by their tone of voice, by their pitch inflections, and by the stresses and accents they place upon certain words and phrases. In this program, we are your guides. We're your speech role models. We'll discuss many areas of speech, including how you can improve the sound of your voice, the mechanics of speech, and how your voice is produced, and how you should care for it.
I'm John Arthur Watkins. You'll learn about public speaking, effective telephone techniques, how to help your children and grandchildren improve their speech, and much more.
We are experienced voice coaches, teachers, and radio TV personalities. We're authors of books and audio tapes in voice and speech. Our products are distributed worldwide. As teachers, authors, and publishers, we've combined our knowledge and experience to produce this audio program.
The fact that you're listening to us proves at least two things. You realize how important it is to your future to speak effectively and expressively, and you understand that accomplished speakers are made, not born. You're correct on both counts.
We all learn to speak during early childhood. We listen to those around us, parents and those who cared for us while our parents worked, grandparents, aunts, uncles, friends, teachers. We imitated their vocal sounds, their speech rhythms, their vocabulary, their mannerisms. Of course, we were also influenced by the media and culture, radio, television, theater, films, recordings, by the amount and type of education that we received, and by the geographical locations in which we lived.
And there, of course, can be the beginning of a genuine problem. Articulate speech is a learned behavior. If your early speech model spoke English with an accent or dialect, if they used incorrect grammar, if their vocabulary was limited, it's likely that you speak that way too. Is that bad? Not necessarily if it doesn't bother you, but remember, others judge you very quickly by the way you sound and by the words you use. That can slow your progress in life, both personally and professionally.
In this program, we want to help you speak effective American English. You must use correct grammar, speak clearly and articulately, possess and use a large vocabulary, pronounce words correctly, and use words with their correct meanings. We want to help you master effective speech. Hugh, tell us, what does speaking effectively mean?
Speaking effectively sets the tone for how you'll be perceived as a person. Speaking effectively involves not only what you say, but how you say it. You have only one chance to make a first impression.
No matter how well-dressed or attractively groomed an individual may be, his or her appearance can be immaterial after that person starts to speak. It's a fact that nearly two-thirds of the time, during employment interviews, a job applicant is judged and then either accepted or rejected within 30 seconds after first beginning to speak. The conversation may continue, but the opportunity has been lost.
It's as if you're making an entrance on stage. That's really what's taking place, you know. Your audience, whether one individual or a sizable group, is about to form some type of impression of you, just as if you were an actor delivering your opening lines.
How many times have you seen someone who appears to be an attractive or interesting person, but when you meet them and hear them speak, your first impression of them drastically changes?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.